MPs from all corners of the political spectrum have expressed their disgust at One Nation's Mark Latham over his vile homophobic attack on New South Wales Independent Alex Greenwich yesterday. The now deleted tweet was sent in response to an article in which Greenwich had branded Latham disgusting. Latham is yet to apologise. His remarks were so vile, even One Nation leader Pauline Hanson has condemned them.
I want you to know that I don't condone them, and neither do my members of parliament or party associates. I think they are disgusting.
Well, Alex Greenwich is with us now. Alex, I know it's been a big, very unpleasant 24 hours for you. How are you doing?
Hi, Hamish. Hi, everyone. Look, I'm doing OK. A homophobic tweet is not what I wanted to be talking about a week after a long election. However, you know, I've got a loving husband, amazing friends and family, and a really supportive electorate. And my thoughts go to people in the LGBT community, particularly the trans community, who deal with these kind of attacks all the time and don't have the same support that I have.
There are calls for an apology to come from Mark Latham, but Alex, do you feel that that's necessary? Would you want one? Do you need one?
I'm not expecting an apology from Mark Latham. I don't need an apology from Mark Latham. I'm really grateful for the support of all of my colleagues in Parliament and the amount of people who have reached out to me. What I do want is my parliamentary colleagues to back me in removing all discrimination that targets the LGBT community and make sure that my community is supported right across New South Wales. That's my priority. That's what I want to talk about.
Mark Latham's just been re-elected to the upper house for another 8 years. Do you think that someone who is willing to say this sort of stuff publicly is fit to serve in office?
Look, I don't begin to understand Mark Latham. I have actually been contacted by a number of One Nation supporters, people who don't usually contact my office, people pretty outraged at the comments that he made. Look, he's going to be in the next parliament. I think the question probably is more, is parliament the right workplace for him? You know, these are not the comments of someone who is well. As I said earlier today, you know, I hope that he's got support around him because this is not the tone of what he said is not what is said by a person who is well or by a person who is reasonable. So I think he probably needs to consider whether this is the right workplace for him.
True to who you are, I think, Alex, is the fact that you are saying, look, I want to refocus this around the legislative changes that I want. What do you actually want to do in this parliament? It seems like you have the bulk of the New South Wales parliament across the aisle sort of wrapping around you now to push forward with this. What are you going to hold them to now?
Well, it was great during the election campaign to get the support of both major parties for my bill to prohibit conversion practices. That's going to be really important. But that's just one part of law reform which I'll be progressing with through my LGBTQI equality bill. We need to update our anti-discrimination laws in New South Wales. Currently, in a private school, you can be fired for being a teacher who's gay, or if you're a kid who comes out, you can be expelled from the school just on that basis. We know that the trans community in New South Wales also is unable to get identity documents that truly reflect their sex or gender identity. And there's long overdue intersex reforms, which we're seeing start in the ACT, and we need to bring to New South Wales. So what I'd really like to see is my colleagues showing their support for not just for me, but showing their support for the wider LGBTI community and joining me to work together to progress these reforms so New South Wales can be a place where LGBTQ people don't face discrimination and we don't have laws that almost give permission for the type of harassment that I faced in the past 24 hours.
Alex, I understand your partner is waiting with a glass of wine just out of frame, so we'll let you go and enjoy that. Thanks for your time tonight.
Thank you, everyone.